الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن، وهو بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ثم أما بعد، أيها الإخوة الأحباب، أيها الأخوات الكريمات، نضر الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه الوجوه المتوضئة. أسجد الله سبحانه وتعالى يا رب العالمين to brighten our faces إن شاء الله in the day of judgment يا أرحم الراحمين. أسجد الله سبحانه وتعالى to bring us all together in the highest level of Jannah, Jannah al-Firdaus al-A'la, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. The way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought us all together here today, in this blessed day, Friday, in this blessed day, the 10th of al-Muharram, Ashura day, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sin, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, deal with us, inshallah, with His mercy, and to enter us Jannah without any accountability, Ya Arham al-Rahmeen, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. Dear brothers, did you hear that they said in Arabic, "Kama tadinu tudan," means what goes around comes around. This is in our Islam. If you do good, you will find it in your way. If you do bad, the result of bad things you are doing, it gonna be also in your way. Let's see some stories from the Sunnah and the Quran al-Kareem is giving us the same meaning, just to declare the point, to try to understand this point, that might be, it will lead us, inshallah, to do good deeds, to follow Sirat al-Mustaqim, to try our best, inshallah, in this dunya, Ya Rabb al-Alameen, to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, while we are seeking His pleasure, not something else. You know the story, which is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, authentic hadith. He was talking about the three travelers, people they were in the desert. The night comes, it was cold, they need some rest, they found a cave, three of them. Since they entered the cave, one of the big rocks descended, was falling, falls from the up to the mountains to the door of the cave and block it completely. Means the cave for these people became like a grave. And these people, they give up. Did they give up? No. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who's telling us this story, الَّذِي لَيَنْتُقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى, Rasulullah is not talking out of his desire or mind. Allah inspired him and they get this information from Allah. But that's why Rasulullah never lie. وَمَا يَنْتُقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى عَلَّمَهُ شَدِيدُ الْقُوَى. فالرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم is telling us about these three people. Subhanallah, when they were blocked into the cave. First one, he said, listen guys, let us look at this now. We can learn something from the hadith. Let us invoke Allah and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with what? With our good deeds. I am sure all of you here, those who are listening to me, we make good deeds somehow. Somehow we make some good deeds. And these people, they remember their good deeds. They said, in this very hard time, death, we are facing death. It's a grave. Let us invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and pray to Him with what? Something we make it for His sake, His pleasure before. Good deeds. First one, he said, اللهم كان لي أبوان شيخان كبيران وكنت لا أغبق قبلهما أهلا ولا مالا. يعني لا أقدم على عليهما أهلا ولا مالا. And سبحان الله, he said that اللهم ارزقنا يا رب العالمين بر والدينا يا أرحم الراحمين. Say أمين. أمين. That man, he said, oh Allah, I used to have my parents, my father and mother. They are so old. And they were first thing in my life, before my wife, before my kids, before anybody else. I used to take care of them. I love them so much. I sit all the time for this serving. Subhanallah. I said one day, I was working and I came late night. And somehow I came late to them. When I reached my house, I found them sleeping, both of them. I was preparing their food and I was standing all night until Salat al-Fajr while they were sleeping, carrying just the food, and my kids, they were crying out of their hunger, and I did not give the food to my kids until I feed my parents first. And he did not wake them up until they wake up. So Fajr time, he start feeding them. He start feeding them, subhanAllah. فاستيقظ فشرب. When they wake up, they drink their milk and they eat their food. Oh Allah, now he's making dua. اللهم إن كنت فعلت ذلك ابتغاء وجهك ففرج عنا ما نحن فيه. Oh Allah, you know that if you know I make it just for your pleasure, for your sake. Oh Allah, help us, let us get out from here. And subhanAllah, the rock was moving a little, but they were not able to get out still. But the rock was moving. Look at this, brothers and sisters. Birr al-walidain, treating parents good in Islam, this is something very important. Even in Islam, he puts birr al-walidain, treating your parents good, not to mistreat them, treating them good in a nice way, before even al-jihad, migration for the sake of Allah, or al-hijrah. الجهاد is ذروة صنم الإسلام, the top of Islam. بر الوالدين better than الجهاد in the sight of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. A man came to Rasulullah, said, يا رسول الله, I'm coming to make a pledge, an oath with you, that I want to migrate for the sake of Allah and the struggle for the sake of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. He said, ألك والدين, your parents still alive? He said, yes, يا رسول الله, go serve them. This is better than الجهاد. Serve your parents. Nowadays we hear everything is upside down. Somebody is putting his parents because they became old in nursery home, and he preferred his wife, treating his wife good, mistreating his mom. Some of them, they are shouting, yelling, cussing, saying bad words to their parents, no respect at all. And even some of them, they killed their parents. They killed their parents. They take their money, their rights, where they are alive. And they said they are مجانين. وعمل حجر عليهم, حجر عليهم وبلاوي سوداء. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا. سيد وبالوالدين إحسانا. الله سبحانه نشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير. Be grateful to Allah and your parents. Worship Allah and be good to your parents. الله سبحانه وتعالى said that. حديث عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه. سيد يا رسول الله, أي الأعمال أحب إلى الله؟ What is the most beloved good deed to Allah سبحانه وتعالى يا رسول الله؟ And رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم instructed him and us. He said, الصلاة على وقتها. The most Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves when you are praying your salah. No, huh? You are praying your salawat على وقتها, in its fixed time. And the beginning of its salah. How many? 5 times salawat, day and night. You have to make this salah in its fixed time, day and night. Don't delay salat al-asr and salat al-dhuhr together, or salat al-maghrib with al-isha. No. You know this is the time of the azan? Mostly 10-20 minutes after the azan. Mostly. And if you make it after the azan, immediately it's better too. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كتابا موقوتا. الله سبحانه وتعالى said that. You have to pray in its time. كتابا موقوتا في وقتها عند سيد الصلاة على وقتها. قلت ثم أي يا رسول الله؟ أنت وات إلس يا رسول الله؟ عبد الله بن مسعود إز أسكند رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said بر الوالدين to be good to your parents, to be nice to your parents, to treat them nicely, to serve them. How to make بر الوالدين? If they are still alive, be nice to them. Say something good to them. Don't shout to them. فلا تقل لهما أوف. Do you know this? This it's not even a word in Arabic. Uff. When you get mad, you say uff. From don't say this even to your parents. Ah, uff. فلا تقل لهما uff. ولا تنهرهما. وقل لهما instead. قل لهما قولا كريما. Say something good to them. Be nice, gentle, kind to your parents. This is how Islam is asking us brothers. What about if they die? Make sadaqa on their behalf. Go make hajj or umrah for them. Subhanallah, make dua your salah for them. Your parents, because of them you are here. قلت ثم أي. See, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said the salah first. And the scholar, they said from the practically way, the salah is the first pillars in Islam. One of the first pillars of Islam. Why? They said the shahadatain, you say it with your tongue. But practically, the salah is the first pillar in Islam. That's why. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم بر الوالدين after الصلاة. قلت ثم أي رسول الله what else يا رسول الله after بر الوالدين. He said الجهاد في سبيل الله. الجهاد is the top of Islam. He said الجهاد في سبيل الله to struggle in the cause of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Look brothers, all of us who are sinning, right? Nobody can pretend that I am pure 100%. كل ابن آدم خطاء. رسول الله said that all the sons of Adam they are mistaken. But the best of those who are mistaken, they are making sin, those who are tawaboon, those who are repenting, coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you make sin and you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive your sin, be good to your mom and your dad and your relatives. If you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you birr, to give you rahmah, mercy, forgiveness, rizq, long life, and to forgive your sin, be good to your parents. A man came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Umar. He said, Ya Rasulullah, أذنبتُ ذنباً عظيماً فهل لي من توبة. He did not say, Ya Rasulullah, I make just a sin. ذنباً عظيماً. Major, major, major sin. Might be one of the seven deadly sins. If you die with it, Jahannam. There is no way. Said, Ya Rasulullah, أَذْنَبْتُ ذَنْبًا عَظِيمًا. I make very major sin, Ya Rasulullah. Is there any tawbah for me? And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, immediately he gave him the answer. هَلْ لَكَ أُمْ? Do you have a mother? What? A mother? What is the relationship of my mother with my great sin or major sin? Forgiveness. If you are good to your mom, you serve your mom, you're nice to your mom. My mom died, a sheikh. You can make dua for her, make sadaqah for her, make anything for her, even if she died. It's a credit for her, subhanAllah. Alaka Umm, do you have a mother? He said, no, Ya Rasulullah, my mom died. And look what Rasulullah is saying. Alaka Khala, do you have an aunt, the sister of your mother? Because Rasulullah said in the hadith, Al-Ummu Khala. Al-Khala to Umm. Your aunt, she's exactly like your mom. Go make birr for her. Al-birrha. Allah will forgive your sin. See, brothers, sometimes we are not opening our eyes to that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking highly in the Holy Quran, Surah Maryam, about one of the prophets. Who? Prophet Yahya, John. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَيْهِ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ جَبَّارًا عَصِيًّا. Yahya, he was very good to his parents. He was not jabbar, tyrant, or asi, somebody disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was not. Second man, he said, Ya Rasulullah, كانت لي ابن عم, ابنة عم. Second man, now he's making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah is telling us his dua. They were three, remember, in the cave. He said, Ya Allah, Allahumma, إنه كانت لي ابنة عم, my cousin. Subhanallah. I used to love her so much. So many times I used to try to seduce her, to talk to her, but she refused.
She was a good lady, young lady. فألمت بها سنة من السنين. She was very poor and sick and she was in need big time. And I told her, listen, I will give you 20 ومئة. 20 يعني 20 plus 100 golden dinar. 20 ومئة دينار. Gold. يعني 120 دينار. Golden دينار. But with the condition, what? I want to make الفاحشة with you. The haram things. Shameful act. زنا يعني. Adultery. She agreed because she was in need for somehow. And when she was about to do this, she said, يا فلان, so and so, اتق الله, fear Allah. ولا تفض الخاتم إلا بحقه. Marry me instead of doing that. اتق الله. And this, when she reminded him by Allah عز وجل, he was a good man. But الشيطان like us nowadays, سبحان الله. And سبحان الله, because he been reminded by Allah, he scared. He said, I give her all the golden money and they left. I lifted her. Ya Allah, if you know I make this for your sake, your pleasure, help us. And the rock was moving more. But they were not able to get out too. Subhanallah. See, brothers, this story, we can learn from that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا تَرَكْتُ بَعْدِي فِتْنَةً أَضَرُّ عَلَى الرِّجَالِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ. فِتْنَةً النِّسَاءِ, the trial, the temptation of women, so hard. Especially nowadays. Might be this woman before they were masakeen. If they come now and they see women nowadays, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Shayateen walking on earth, والله العظيم. They knew how to get men like this from the streets. And the haram is free now. You know, الحلال, you can pay money for it. The haram is free. They can give you money to make haram now. Yes, we are in the time of fitna. That's why we can learn from this story of this man. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من يضمن لي ما بين فكيه وما بين فخذيه أضمن له الجنة. If you guaranteed your tongue between two of your jaws, your tongue not to backbite, to slander, to talk bad about someone in his absence, subhanAllah, easy. People now easy, they can make websites and they can talk about anybody. Let them go to hell. Hell, Allah the one who he knows who's the correct and who's the That's the right way or in a better way. Forget about people. If somebody's talking about you, just tell him go to hell. I will see you inshallah in the hereafter. There is a court there. We're going to talk with Allah Azza wa Jal. That's it. Let people talk. Who cares? Who cares? You have a mission. Do it. Don't look around. That's it. This is the real Muslim. Rasulullah Sallam was telling Ali ibn Abi Talib when he gave him the flag, the banner during the Khaybar time. He said, Ya Ali, take it and never look around. Don't look back. And when Ali ibn Abi Talib was about to go, he said, Ya Ali! Sayyidina Ali, did he turn his face? He did not. He said, Yes, Ya Rasulullah. He did not turn his face to him. He said, لَإِنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكِرًا رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمْرِ النَّعَمِ. Before fighting them, let guide them to Islam first. Deliver Islam to them first. If Allah guide one person because of you, better than the dunya وما فيها. Better than all of this world. Subhanallah. But the point here is, fitna to nisa, big fitna. And if you guard your tongue from saying bad things about anybody, and if you guard your private part, don't make zina, adultery, fornication. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I guarantee Jannah for you. غض البصر, keep your gaze away from looking to the haram. Subhanallah. And we, when we remember something like that, we have very good example in the Holy Quran, the best of the stories, Yusuf alayhi salam. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about him.
وراودته التي هو في بيتها عن نفسه وغلقت الأبواب وقالت هيت لك قال معاذ الله قال معاذ الله إنه ربي أحسن مثواي إنه لا يفلح الظالمون ولقد همت به وهم بها لولا أن رأى برهان ربه كذلك لنصرف عنه السوء والفحشاء إنه من عبادنا المخلصين.
The sincerity of Prophet Yusuf عليه السلام saved him from the wife of Al-Aziz and the women too because he'd been seduced by not just Zulaykha, the wife of Al-Aziz. By all of the women. تسويه سيد والا تصرف عني كيدهن all of them اصب اليهن واكن من الجاهلين. That's why the one who disobeyed Allah عز وجل is جاهل, he's ignorant during this time. واكن من الجاهلين. Don't disobey Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And this message for the youth, especially now, there is no raqib, there is no shaheed. I was in the program before 2 days, for 2 hours in the, one of the TVs here, we're talking about the changing the gender for the kids now in the schools. There is a book, they call it It's Perfectly. عزم الله يا مشترجين. الله حرام والله. It's perfectly normal, that book, they are teaching it, this, the kids here, fourth grade, this book. It's all naked, how boy can sleep with boy, girl with girl, and the kid in the school, they can, the teacher can ask him, well, would you like to be she or he, if he said he or she? They pay $1.3 million for his surgery, and just the kid will sign, that's it, without even telling his parents. If you want to be she or he, you don't know. There are too many things. But that's why we have to raise our kids, start with the parents. We have to educate our kids. We have to talk to our kids. When you see a boy and he became still خلاص not mature and he became almost mature, we have to, the father, he was sitting with him, you're a boy. Allah created you like this. You're not supposed to act like a girl. You have to educate him. And the girl, the same thing. You're a girl, her mom must educate her. That's because the school, you don't know what's going on the school. 7 o'clock to 3 o'clock, you don't know what's going on there. We have to, we are Muslims, we have our own identity. After 2, 3, 4 generations from now, I don't know what's going to happen. Yes, brothers, it's a serious matter. Wallahi. That's why al-fahisha is haram. Ask yourself, if you have any kind of temptation or fitna like this, what are you going to do? If any woman going to seduce you and going to ask you for haram, what are you going to do? Are you going to do like Sayyidina Yusuf or that like this man? When somebody reminds you by Allah, you're going to stop or you're going to do the zina? You're going to do the haram, you drink al-khamr. You do all of this haram, brothers. Subhanallah. That man, he said, oh Allah, you know if I make this for your sake, help us. The third one, he said, Ya Rab, Allahumma inni istajartu ujara fa'ataytuhum ajrahum. I was hiring some men to work for me. I was a businessman. And I give them, each one of them, his wage. Except one of them, he just left without taking the money. I was investing his little money, subhanAllah, after a while, years. That man, his money grow, mashallah. He had the cattle, cows, sheep, and the slaves, raqiq, too many. He came, he said, give me my wage after years. I told him, do you know this, all of this for you? He said, are you making fun of me? He said, no, I invested your money. This is yours. And subhanAllah, in the end, this man, he said, oh Allah, if you know, I make this for your sake. Subhanallah, help us. And the rock was moving completely and they get out. Rasulullah said, they were walking as if Rasulullah seeing them. فَخَرَجُوا يَمْشُونَ. They get out from the cave walking. Subhanallah. But that's why you have to learn, dear brothers, dear sisters, this is the way. This is the way. روى اليافعي في كتابه مرآة الجنان. اليافعي, he mentioned in his book, the name of his book, مرآة الجنان, during the time of الخليفة المتوكل, one of the caliphs, Muslims. A man, his wazir, his name was Ibn Ziyad. The wazir of الخليفة المتوكل, his name was Ibn Ziyad. That kind of prime minister or wazir, he was so bad man. Qasi, harsh, zalim, oppressor, an oppressor man. Anybody he used to fight with him and he don't like with him in the community, he used to bring him and put him into a box and that box full of nails. After a while, subhanAllah, he will bleed and he will die. And one time, because subhanAllah, people they used to beg him, please have mercy, have mercy. He said, no. Mercy means for me weakness. I don't have mercy for anybody. And one day, al-Khalifa al-Mutawakkil, al-Khalifa himself, he get mad of that wazir. Where he puts him? In the same box. In the same box. After 40 days, he died into the same box. He used to cry for al-Khalifa, please have mercy. And they said, no. He used to deal with him the same. Mercy is weakness. I will not have mercy on you. Because you did not have that mercy for people before you. That's why, subhanAllah, we have to know that. Dear brothers, dear sisters, this is sunnah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كل إنسان سيشرب من الكأس الذي سقى فيها غيره. You're gonna drink from the same cup. You give it to others. You understand what I'm saying? You're gonna drink from the same cup. You give it to others. Be nice. Be kind. Make good deeds. Have mercy. All of this. Otherwise, subhanAllah, if you be harsh and bad, somebody else will come to you with the same thing. نحن نحصد ما زرعناه. Whatever seeds you planted, this is what you're gonna get it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what goes around comes around, the brothers. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they drove him out from Mecca alone with Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, crying. And he was saying, talking to Mecca, because if its people get me out of it, I would love to stay in Mecca all of my life. And he was crying, and Allah sent in Quran to him, إِنَّ الَّذِي فَرَضَ عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لَرَادُّكَ إِلَىٰ مَعَادْ Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام. Don't cry. Allah swore by himself, the one who revealed the Quran to Rasulullah. He said, I will bring you back. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he came back to Mecca, he came back with 10,000 soldiers. And they entered from all doors of Mecca. Rasulullah was going, subhanAllah, hiding himself with Abu Bakr al-Siddiq when he migrated. See? But that's why, be careful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying الجزاء من جنس العمل. وهل جزاء الإحسان إلا الإحسان. Sayyidina Ibrahim, Prophet Ibrahim, they chained his hand with his neck and his foot. And he was like a bowl. And they threw him, they put him in the machine, like they call it المنجنيق. They put him in the machine. And they throw him like he was ruling on air like that, and they put him into the fire. He was naked because the fire ate his clothes. And subhanAllah, Allah said, Ya Ibrahim, you're gonna be first person even before Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I will close you on the day of judgment. أول من يكسى يوم القيامة Prophet Ibrahim. Because he was naked one day, subhanAllah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَهِيمٍ. Allah gave order to the fire. Don't touch Ibrahim. Cool. Calm in him. Subhanallah. This is Sayyidina Ibrahim and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَمْتَدَّتْ أَيْدِي إِخْوَةِ يُوسُفْ تَطْلُبُ الصَّدَقَةَ إِلَّا لِأَنَّهَا بَاعَتْهُ فَقَبَضَتْهُ فَقَبَضَتْ ثَمَنًا بخس. Subhanallah. سواء بسواء وهذه بتلك. The brothers of Musa, of Yusuf alayhi salam, they went to Egypt begging him for sadaqah, for food. Why? Because they sold him before with little money to the people. They sold Yusuf himself. Now they are coming begging him for sadaqah. See, brothers, one by one. One by one. Don't think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just is giving you like this. And that you have to count everything. You have to think about everything. You have to consider everything. Why Allah is giving me money but is not giving somebody else? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make me healthy but somebody else sick? May Allah gives me children, but somebody else not. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ فِي مَا أَتَاكُمْ. He's examining you. He's testing you. Brothers, مَنْ كَسَرَ كُسِرْ. If you break someone, somebody else will break you. وَمَنْ جَبَرَ جُبِرْ. If you maintain somebody's feeling, Allah will send somebody to maintain your feeling. Subhanallah. That's why. وَمَنْ قَسَى قُسِيَ عَلَيْهِ. If you will be harsh, somebody harsh will come to you in one day. وَمَنْ لَانَ أَلَانَ اللَّهُ لَهُ الْقُلُوبُ وَالسَّخْرِ. If you will be soft and nice and kind, Allah will soften the hearts of people to you, not just the hearts of people, the rocks will be soft for you. I give you دليل. Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, when he was raising the foundation of the Kaaba, he was standing above big rock. What is that rock now? It is in the Kaaba, they call it Maqam Ibrahim. When you make tawaf, you look in it, you see the footprint of Prophet Ibrahim. Why? The scholar, they said, because his heart was very soft. Allah softened the rock under his foot. Subhanallah. Did you see anybody in the world standing above a rock and his footprint there? No, just only Sayyidina Ibrahim. Why? Because his heart was very soft. Was nice, kind. Inna Ibrahim la halimun awahul munib. Allah said in the Holy Quran. Dear brothers, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to soften our hearts, Ya Rabb al-Alameen. And remember that all the time, what goes around comes around. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم كل من آدم خطاء وخير خطيئة توب توب إلى الله واستغفره.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي المؤمنين، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Before I end my khutbah, we have a good news. MashaAllah, the executive committee of the masjid, MashaAllah, they're making a new app for the masjid. InshaAllah, رب العالمين. Just you have this card, scan it, and you get the whole information about the masjid, the time of the salah, everything regarding the masjid, everything about the masjid, especially the time of the salah. You don't have to ask the sheikh anymore. You have to ask anybody. It is there. Everything is there. Just scan it. I will stay up to date, Islamic Center of Reseda, download our app, scan it. Just here, put your phone and scan it. That's all. This is what we need from you, inshallah. Also, I have this before I leave my khutbah. Please do not park in the Senior Citizen Center. Yes, please do not park there. Do not park there. Also, we need to reduce the traffic in the parking in the first prayer. We need at least 30 to 40 brothers, if they can, come with their cars for second prayer, like 2 o'clock from the first prayer, because we have to balance the numbers because of the parking lot is not enough. I think the message is clear, inshallah. اللهم إني داعٍ فأمنوا، اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، لك يا ربي سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا تقبل منا فإنك أنت السميع العليم، واغفر لنا فإنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. يا ربنا يا الله، save us يا أرحم الراحمين from any kind of harm. Save us يا رب العالمين from any kind of sickness, poverty, harm, any kind of pain يا أرحم الراحمين. Today the way you saved Musa عليه السلام from Pharaoh, today is the 10th of Muharram. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us يا رب العالمين and all Muslim Ummah يا رب العالمين from any kind of bad things يا رب العالمين. ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا وانصرنا ولا تنصر علينا، واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، وارحم موتانا موتى المسلمين، اشف من كان منا مريضا يا رب العالمين، وتب علينا يا ارحم الراحمين. عباد الله، ان الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى ينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم. وأقم الصلاة.